flip the switch, pull the lever, punch the code. And that's exactly what we did. So let's get into this and see what changes there are thus far for Lars in the CNT beta. You have immediate access to your character's rage drive in the form of heat smash. You pop heat, heat burst, pop heat again, and your character performs the heat smash. You can really connect pressure move into pressure move, which very much reminds me of the Tekken 7 rage drive. For all intents and purposes, the utility of heat is it acts as a combo ender in a rage drive to mount a comeback or shred through that last bit of your opponent's health to get them out the game. Key charge is still in the game for those who use it for whatever you use it for. 10 hit combo, still in the game. Reports were, before I got my hands in the game, that Lars feels heavier, like moving Leo around in Tekken 7. Well, I can report now that moving him around does feel different. But a lot of it might just be the PlayStation 5 controller. Maybe. The devs have stated that they really didn't mess with movement all that much. I was working on an install card project. Silly me. But the devs just went ahead and told us what the character's heat engages are. As of course they would. Lars has 5. 3 of which are locked behind stances. And speaking of, it's a great time to mention that unlike what little old Empire here wanted, a Lars that kind of was going to be pushed away from being so stance heavy, he's been revamped to be the exact opposite. Moves that force you to go into stances. However, I cannot say that that is a bad thing. So, let's look at these heat engagers. Delta Slicer. I'd imagine on normal hit, only the first 2 attacks are guaranteed, just like in Tekken 7. And you get the whole thing on counter hit. Without heat, this string no longer knocks down, but rather places your foe in crouch. In Delta Slicer, no longer wall splats. Electric Jolt. It might have gotten a range buff, or considering the input has been changed to 3+4, the forward motion that used to occur from such inputs, the forward, it may have simply been baked into the move. Future Empire here, kind of, sorta. I have to cut in here to say the range of this move is just great. Now a single binded button. I'd say this is a great tool, and since it's a part of Lars' install card, as in the devs really want you to use this move, I'd say this is a good get-in tool or keep-out tool for Lars in Tekken 8. And it looks safe on block, just like in Tekken 7. Double Barrel. During dynamic entry, 1-2. Without heat, this move is the same as it ever was, and it's still wall splats. Bow Shock. A homing move. Mid. Goes over lows and automatically transitions to silent entry if there is no heat available on hit. I know this does chip, and it looks to have good plus frames on block. Lightning Thrust. During silent entry, 1. The zoom effect is gone, otherwise it's the same weapon from Tekken 7. Here's where the game makes people quite confused with heat burst and dash and splash. Myself included. I was under the impression, while in heat state, all heat engagers canceled into a dasher on hit for a combo. Well, that is not the case. Delta Slicer, canceled, does not grant the follow-up combo opportunity that Electric Jolt does. In both Delta Slicer and Bow Shock, do not have this effect as far as I can tell. But Lightning Thrust, Double Barrel, and Electric Jolt, they all do grant the combo. As far as I can tell, Delta Slicer, not safe on block, you can make it safe and continue to pressure with the Heat Dash. That's the utility there. Spiral Kick, doesn't exist anymore. Opponents electing to stand guard, once allowing Lars to access those sweet plus frames, has been replaced with Bowshock. But as aforementioned, Bowshock seems to be plus on block as well. And it's homing, and it goes over lows. It's an upgrade for sure. Flashing Strike doesn't exist anymore, replaced seemingly by Flash Bullet. Much more on this later. Lightning Assault High, Lightning Assault Middle are both gone, because Lars is a somewhat different character now. Bolt Smash is gone with the Lightning too. A litany of Lars' moves from Tekken 7 have been brought over to 8. I'm going over attacks in this section that have altered properties from 7 to 8. Legionnaire Spin can now shift into Limited Entry, this kind of sort of new stance. Spinning Cutter no longer causes the Tailspin screw, so I'm left to wonder what the fuck this move is for. Like, why is it in the game? Judging by this icon, you can use it to balcony break and break through walls. That's its single allocated use. HE Combo is now a Tailspin attack on an aerial opponent. Raw crushes as well, and you can still charge it up. Inductance no longer launches on counter hit, which, you know, sucks. Chevron Slash does not knock down on counter hit. Lars in Tekken 8, still deceptible to sidestepping as in 7, this move is still as important as ever. No longer wall splats on counter hit as well. Gilbert Cannon has been allocated to a tornado move on an aerial opponent, and it's still wall splats. Double Pulse. I've heard rumors through the Lightning that this no longer grants plus frames on hits. So why sacrifice your life for 5 more damage compared to the new Cross Transistor? The end result on hit does look like what the end of HE Combo used to, and that doesn't grant any plus frames on hit either in Tekken 7. Time will tell. This move no longer wall crush. And Windliner no longer launches on counter hit. Again, just sucks. Still wall splats. And though I didn't catch it at the time, apparently, this move is now safe.
At the same, right?
Yeah, it's safe. Red Sprite does chip as part of that new aspect of the game in wall splats. And Elbow Corona does chip as well, still launches on counter. Tower Cannon has a significant change. It's now a normal launcher, and it's the type that Lydia has with this move here. You can combo with Limited Entry 2 for big, big damage. In other words, the devs really want you to use this move. I think the utility here is an opponent whiffing a high attack or throw, and you duck and punish. Definitely has plus frames on block as well. With Shockwave, there is no longer a guaranteed stomp anymore. It's a Shadow Cutter for 36 damage instead. Rimfire transitions to Lars' Avalanche series on hit, the devs hinting heavily to players to use this more. Avalanche Flip Breakdown now lands in side switches on normal hits, and Stack Up can now be done during Dynamic Entry. On normal hits, I don't even think you have plus frames. Perhaps mildly? Yeah, I'll use that word there. But on counter hit, it forces a hand to the ground knockdown, just like Leo in Tekken 7. She gets guaranteed damage when placing an opponent in this state. And now, so too, does Lars. Shifting from Stack Up into Silent Entry 1, Lightning Thrust. It combos and elects a Heat State. That's pretty fucking cool. Turbine Hook immediately tailspins on counter hit now, limiting your combo paths as we know it. But that, of course, is when all the heat stuff comes into play to more than likely overcompensate for this. Ring Current, a natural combo that shifts into limited entry. A good portion of these new large strings are linked in this way. Fairly confident this is also safe. Yeah, it's definitely safe. Cross Transistor, a low high string that automatically transitions to dynamic entry with some plus frames. As I said at the beginning of this, the devs are linking Lars to his stances more, becoming one in the same. Glassbreaker transitions into limited entry, pressing down. The devs, Lars stances, one in the same. Integrated. This is what it is now. Lars is the stances is Lars. That's where we are. Legionnaire's Shot. The second part of Legionnaire's Spin, this is like plus one, maybe. But at least there is a low out of Din that won't have you gambling with your life, taking the place of Double Pulse here. Entangling Ejector. The devs just have a way of naming Lars moves, don't they? It's a tailspin attack on an opponent in the air, replaces Bolt Smash in a way, as it seems to be a safe mid out of Silent Entry. Blasting Smack. Disrespectful ass name. Once this was Avalanche Spike. Blasting Smack is a low attack from limited entry that forces crouch and side switches while within heat, taking on the name of Blue Jet when doing so. Rising Force, the once key charge move. Now the two button from limited entry. It seems to have a fair amount of evasive properties. Knocks the enemy away on block, causes chip, and tail spins while in heat. Rebellion. During heat, highly charged, forward advancing move. Looks like great plus frames on hit or block. Lars shifts into silent entry after the shoulder charge, telling me, like with other moves that we have seen, every character in Tekken 8 is going to have some offensive pressure move tied to heat. And for Lars, Rebellion is that move. Flash Bullet. I save this one for last because Flash Bullet may be Lars' best new move. And if not, at bare minimum, your new best friend with all the things you can do with it. A good range mid attack that's what? 13, 15 frames? That is a bunch of moves in one. On normal hit, this is a poke if you hold back, risking relatively nothing. No stances to get in and out of. If you let the move fully rock and it lands on counter hit, Lars goes into silent entry for extra damage and great ground game setup. Another scenario, you land a normal hit, shift into Sin, opponent presses, Electric Volley, opponent doesn't press, Turbine Hook, or shift into Dynamic to try to catch them whiffing a button. You can shift into limited entry as well. There is a lot packed in this one move. This is a beta test, so I wondered how enemies would react to the various states of play Flash Bullet can go into. Namely, would they let me shift about? Results varied, but there was a good amount of success. I really think this move is one of them ones. All attacks marked by the tornado move icon seem to have this wall flip property, similar to certain moves that wall bounced in Tekken 7. HE combo, Gilbert Cannon, Surge Blast, Streamer, Into the Storm, Entangling Injector, All of these can re-wall splat an opponent, subject to change. Keep them in mind, nonetheless. This is just the beginning of my Lars Tekken 8 coverage. I'm building a little army of Lars content, as well as other characters here on the channel. Join the new wave as we move toward a new era in Tekken. Oh yeah. And Lars can do this now. Oh, Tekken 8 is gonna be fun.